Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a Cabergén. A what? A what? A Cabergén. Basically, like a stone, a crystal, made out of acrylic. So, I have already prepped and applied a tip to Olivia's nail. And I am going to use the Nail Prep Dehydrator to dehydrate that nail plate. And then we are going to use the acid-based primer. You don't need a lot. Just on the natural nail. First of all, I'm going to create a natural looking nail. And I'm creating a natural looking nail, so when Olivia wants to change her design, we can literally just e-file off the gel polish and we can create a new look. So to create this natural nail, I am using the natural powder. That's like a milky colour. I'm going to start at the tip and drag it down. You can see that's a real natural colour. Just want a tiny bit more blending up to the centre of this nail plate. So I'm going to blend that back and then I'm going to use True Pink. Now True Pink is a transparent pink. It's a very soft colour, so it'll be very natural. And I'm going to place that on side to side, and then we will take that over the top of the natural. And that'll just create a lovely natural nail. So it's a perfect base for anybody that wears gel polish and wants to have a natural nail looking underneath, and they can always change their design. This nail is also a really easy nail to fill. So when you do your backfills, you're just gonna fill it with your True Pink. So it's low maintenance, not high maintenance like me.
Hashtag still single.
Yes, still single. Yeah, no message. So I'm going to pinch this nail because I do want it to have a nice C curve. I want it to have some strength. I'm going to file this nail now, doing my normal filing routine. I've got to make sure that back's nice and flush and the sidewalls are nice and straight. Doing a soft square, so you want to keep those edges slightly rounded. I'm just going to buff over now to smooth that nail. So if you get people coming in, like your clients come in and they can't really wear nails, but they so desperately want to wear nails and they're not really allowed to wear nails in their line of work, you can create a nail like this. Because it looks so natural. I'm going to wipe over with acetone. Going to clean it up and smooth it out. Now we are ready for gel polish application. It's a gorgeous blue, like a cobalt blue. It's 961. So I'm going to do two coats of colour. Pop me that in the lamp. I'm So now that's cured, I'm going to apply the Urban Graffiti top coat. This is a tack free top coat. So this is the base, and what we're going to use is in this wheel we have this. We have other sizes and other shapes, but I'm going to use that one today. I have used, there's that little nail that I was having a play with. See this one? So you can see I've used the different sizes and different shapes. I'm just playing around and seeing what I could do with it. So I'm going to demonstrate to you the big mahoosive one because I love it. Yeah, so we'll put it about there. We want it to look like a piece of jewellery. Yeah, so I'm going to put a layer of the Urban Graffiti top coat on. Only a nice thin layer. And this will just hold it in place. It's not going to be secure enough on its own. So if you're thinking you can just add the ring and just sort of add the ring into the top coat, it wouldn't stay on for very long if we relied on just the top coat. We have to put another product on, which we will do in a minute. Alright, pop me that in the lamp. Next I'm going to use Carnival in Rio, which is a gorgeous acrylic powder that is absolutely jam-packed with glitter. So you're going to pick up bead of this, place it in the middle of your frame, and what you want to do is make sure that stays nice and domed. You want to make sure it just touches the frame for that ring, because that will hold it in place. If it goes a bit too flat, if you look at the side view, I think it's a little bit flat, so I'm going to get a little bit more product. And just bring that up a little bit. Once that's dry, it's still a little bit sticky. So we're not dry yet. You've got to wait for this to dry before you move on to the next step, which is very boring. Waiting for things to dry.
2,000 years later.
So this acrylic is what's going to help this frame to stay on as well. It's going to help it to not come off. You won't be able to peck it off or anything like that because the acrylic is touching. That's what I said. You make sure that you touch, very slightly touch, that gold ring. Now that's dry, going to take the Urban Graffiti top coat and in a circular motion you're going to apply that, take off the excess off your brush, and then just want to make sure you go over all of the stone, and then we're going to use some of the gold micro beads. I'm only going to use 4. I'm going to put one here. And one here. Here, one here. So they look like little clasps holding the stone down. Pop that into the lamp. I'm going to use Mega Gloss. And I'm using Mega Gloss because it's a thicker consistency and it'll hold things on a lot better. So I'm going to use dotting tool to just apply some of it here, and then we're going to pick up these other metal pieces. Place them on so they kind of look like a necklace chain. And I also want to pop a gold little stud right at the tip. Stay still. Oh yes, it's like a vintage necklace. Right, I need to pop that in. What I'm going to do now is finish with some cuticle oil. So you could do that in any colour. I just think the background colour, this cobalt blue, looks beautiful against the...
It looks very royal.
It does, doesn't it?
It does.
The royal blue.
The royal blue.
Looks very royal.
Is it royal blue, is it?
Well, it's a royal blue colour, isn't it? Cobalt blue, royal blue. But I think it matches perfectly with the acrylic that we've used, that Carnival in Rio colour. It's like a little necklace. So you don't need to wear accessories around your neck and your wrists. You wear them on your nails. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below in the description box. Don't forget to subscribe and like. You can even share this video, because every time you share this video,
a fairy gets its wings.
A fairy gets its wings. Oh my god, I was trying to think of something really cool, but I'll see you soon. See you in the next video. Bye.